to this channel. My name is Sarah. Today I wanted to talk to you about my fabric shopping in Tokyo. I just got back from, I think, was it yesterday? I'm so confused what time it is, what day it is. I'm still jet lagged, but I just got back yesterday morning from Tokyo. I was in Taipei for a week and then Tokyo for a week for work, and work only took up a week, and then there was travel time, and then I took off a few days on either end to explore both Taipei and Tokyo. And I have so much footage. If you followed along on Instagram, I did share my daily adventures, but that's over now. I'm home. I'm now looking over all of the footage that I took, and I'd like to create at least one video where I share these adventures with you, even though they're not entirely related to sewing. Just in case you're interested in seeing my travels as well, I do wear all handmade clothes. Usually, and I usually do get a little bit of fabric shopping in. Today, in this video, I did exactly that. I spent an entire morning in Nippori, which is known as being an area of Tokyo where there are lots and lots of fabric shops and haberdasheries and secondhand clothes store where you can go shopping. And I have been there before. This is my second time going, but the first time I went in 2019, I actually couldn't make it except for on a Sunday. And unfortunately, that Sunday, almost all the shops were closed. It was a ghost town. And it was so sad. I found one or two shops open. It was spare pickings. So I went back this year on a Monday and almost all the fabric shops were open. It was fantastic. There was so much to choose from and it was almost overwhelming how many fabric shops there were. I've never seen so many in one place. There were at least 20 fabric shops and that was really cool. So I had to narrow it down a little bit. I decided not only did I have to be a little bit selective when it came to what kinds of fabrics because my suitcase is only so big and I'm only so strong. And I also wanted to look for fabrics that I couldn't find in Paris or in Europe in general online. So even though I saw a few very nice looking fabrics and really lovely colors, if it was something that I thought I could find easily or somewhat easily at home, I didn't pick them. And then I did also want to get some fabrics that were traditionally Japanese style or made in Japan and with Japanese prints. And so I'm really excited. I did find a few really lovely things and especially a few haberdashery items as well. So let me share that with you now. Before I begin, I did want to share with you a resource because there is a website all about Nippori Fabric Town, created I think by the district or the city, and it has information in Japanese and English, a map showing where all the shops are and their names in English, and even showing different businesses, for example, restaurants that are around the neighborhood, or haberdasheries, clothing shops, and even 7-Eleven if you need to go to an ATM and get out some more money, for example, which is very useful. They even have a little YouTube video showing Nippori Fabric Town and explaining all the different things you can find there, even the mascot who's sometimes walking around. I didn't see him, but I did keep my eye out for him. I think that it's a great resource. It definitely made me feel welcome as a foreigner in Nippori Fabric Town, even though I knew that most of the shop owners probably wouldn't speak very much English, and they didn't, but it was okay. I felt welcome. Everybody was very friendly. So if you're ever in Tokyo and you have some time to go check out the Nippori Fabric Town, I highly recommend it. So the first fabric shop that I purchased fabric at, it was called Mihama. It is a fabric shop that sells traditionally printed Japanese fabrics for, I think, the creation of kimono. It was really fascinating because they had all kinds of very traditionally Japanese prints, ranging from lots of sakura prints to prints for children. And it was really, really cool. Lots of colors that I hadn't seen before, and a color coordination system where you could figure out which colors you wanted based on what was written on the packaging. All of the fabrics were pre-packaged and pre-cut, and you can see on the package, it tells you how much is inside. And they did have samples up of each fabric out of the packaging so that you could touch it and see it in coloring outside of the plastic, but this is what I bought. I haven't unpackaged it yet because it was just so convenient for taking home in my suitcase, but I will take them out of the packages for you now. So the first fabric that I purchased from there is this really beautiful dark blue fabric. And I think all the fabric that I purchased, I think they're all 100% cotton, but it's got this really cool texture to it. It's got like, I don't know if you can see, sort of a pebbly texture. And I love this color blue. It's kind of a crisper cotton. I don't know if you can see that. But yeah, this, I saw this and they had this print in a few different colors and I just absolutely loved this one with the sakura blossoms on this dark blue background with purple and pink and a little bit of green. And I thought that this would complement my coloring a little bit better than the other colors, because a lot of them were a little bit more orange or a little bit more of a yellowy green. They were also beautiful. It was very, very hard to pick, but I picked this one and I got 2 meters of this. I'm not entirely sure what I want to make with it yet, but I thought that maybe I could make a cielo top by Closet Core Patterns, or I could probably get a dress out of this, like a silver Una dress, but I will see. I absolutely love this texture. I haven't seen this texture ever really in fabric in a shop. And it's just really cool. So I'm really excited that I got that one. And once I think of something to make with it, I will let you know. And hopefully I'll figure out something soon. So then the next 4 fabrics I bought in a bundle. So these are cuts of 1 meter each, and it was sold for 800 yen, which is about 6 euros, I think. I couldn't choose all the colors, but I really loved this one, for example. And they didn't have these available in larger lengths, so I think they're remnants, but I couldn't entirely understand. Let me show you all of them out of their packages. So first there's this one, which I absolutely love for the different colors. Let me unfold it entirely. And they're all very thin, they're not very thick. This one's soft, it's really nice. And there's this teeny tiny texture to it, as though there are tiny, tiny pleats in the fabric, and it's really nice. And I have a meter of this one, so all of these are a meter. And yeah, I really love this one. I love the purple, I love the swirly design in the back. It's just absolutely gorgeous. I don't know what I'm gonna do with it yet. Oh, I love this one. I love the colors in this one especially. And then there's this one, which is a little bit more of a paisley. And it does have a bit of a shine in the sunlight, and also that kind of interesting texture with the stripes. I love this color blue, and I think it's really cool. Maybe it'd be nice in a skirt or something, and it's just so soft. It's really nice cotton, I think. It's really smooth, and so I think it'll be really nice against my skin no matter what I make with it. And then this one has a little bit more contrasting colors with the pink and red. And the contrast I find is really striking. And this one again has that like striped texture to it, and it's really, really smooth. I love the contrast between dark blue and the pinks and the whites and things. I don't really know what to do with these fabrics, but other than make skirts with them, I think that the print is a little bit too busy to go next to my face in a blouse or something. But I have a meter of this one too, and I'm excited to make something with it. It's just absolutely beautiful. Oh. And then the last remnant that I got in the remnant package was this one. It's like the blue one with the paisley. It's the same print and the same texture, but in this darker rose color, or like a powdery rose. And it's really lovely. I think that this one is, I'm not sure if it goes very well with my skin. Maybe. Sometimes pink looks good, sometimes it does not, but I'll see. So yeah, these are the two together, the ones that look very, very similar. With the same print, and yeah, the colors go together pretty well, so maybe I'll make something with the two of them together. So those are all the remnants that I got. Since they were sold in packs of 4, I couldn't pick exactly which ones that I wanted, but these 4 looked the nicest, and I'm really excited that I got those. And especially this pink color, I feel like I see this pink color a lot in Japanese fabrics, especially in the kimono that I saw in the streets and what people were wearing. And yeah, I think it'd be really cool to create something with that. And then the last fabric that I bought was a little bit more expensive, and it's this one. And I bought 4 meters. So there are 2 meters each cut in these packages. And let me take them out so I can show you. So it is this sakura sort of print with these like sakura flowers, and it's got a little bit of a gold sheen to it. I don't know if you can see that. And also that little bumpy stripe effect to create some texture. I really love, I don't know if you can see it, but there's a really faint pattern in white behind the flowers, and it's just so beautiful. And then the stripes go horizontally. Oh, how gorgeous is that? I love this color. And I love that they're flowers. I love the sakura season, and I would really, really love to be in Tokyo or in Japan in general during the sakura season, even though I know it's super, super touristy. I think that it's popular for a reason. I think it's really, really beautiful. And I love that Japan really celebrates seasons all the time. So while I was there, it was strawberry season, and there were a lot of strawberry themed goodies or things in shops, even regular brands like in beer, soda, candies. There was Ichigo Daifuku Mochi as well, and I got some, and it was delicious. Oh my goodness. I need to find that in Paris as well because it was just absolutely delicious, although it's not strawberry season in France right now. This is just absolutely gorgeous, and I know exactly what I want to make with this. So I've been thinking about what I want to make for my wedding, and I've been thinking especially about the clothes that I'm going to wear around the wedding because it's an entire weekend affair. And my photographer told me to think of the outfit that I'll be wearing when I'm getting ready because she'll be there taking pictures, and I've decided that I would like to make a robe out of this one, and I think I'm going to make the Closet Core Patterns Veronique robe. It is somewhat Japanese kimono inspired in that it's similar to some of the shaping of a Japanese kimono, but it's obviously not a kimono. And I think that it would look really, really beautiful in this fabric. I think I might play around with the direction of the print. Selvage to selvage, it's horizontal, but I could probably play with it a little bit. I have 4 meters. I'm not sure if the fact that they're already cut into 2 meter segments is going to cause problems or not. I will see. I absolutely adore this. It's very, very smooth, but it's crisp as well, so I think it'll hold the shape really nicely, and I think it looks good next to my face. Not that I'm cuddling with my fabric, but it's really soft. And I don't think it's too overwhelming as a print. I think that it will look okay, and I'm excited. So I will be probably showing you how I'm making that robe if I have time. I'm a little bit worried that I won't have enough time to make this robe because I still have my wedding dress to make. And I just received the instructions while I was in Taipei, and so I know how much fabric and the kind of materials that I need to buy to make it, but my wedding is in less than 3 months now, and I need to make that wedding dress, and so I think I will have time to make this robe. We'll see, but if I don't get to it, I will make a robe out of this anyways. I did buy 4 meters and that's enough. It means a lot to me to be able to have access to Japan, to be able to speak a little bit of Japanese, and to have now some of this fabric because my grandmother was actually from Japan, Japanese, and when she would go to Japan, she would bring back kimono for me. I don't have them anymore and I was very small, so, but I loved wearing them and I didn't know exactly how to wear them correctly, but I think that I would like something that is Japanese inspired and with Japanese fabric, like a little bit of Japanese culture in my wedding. Even though I don't know it very, very well, I still feel drawn to it, and I think that's partly because of my grandmother and the time that I spent with her while she was alive. And yeah, I think it would be really special for me to have this with me on my wedding day. Also, this fabric is gorgeous, so I'm excited to work with it. So the next shop that I visited was actually a haberdashery called Tomato. It's also a fabric store, but they have a Tomato of haberdashery as well. And at first I thought, oh, I'll probably find about the same things that I'll find in France, but no, not at all. And I quickly realized that they had all kinds of things that I couldn't find in France, especially from different brands. So there were some things that I could definitely find of equal quality in French brands or European or American brands. But I decided to purchase some Japanese hand sewing needles. So especially, for example, these tulip needles. I don't know if you can see them, but I know that I was watching a Bernadette Banner video. I'm not sure if you follow her too. I'll link her channel below, but she's very fascinating. And she recommends these tulip hand sewing needles. I'm not sure if I got the right size. This is size 8 and they look a little bit thick. So they might be for thicker projects like coats, but I'll see. And I've always wanted to try those and they're hard to get where I live. And then I also wanted to try these clover hand sewing needles. They're sizes 7 to 10. So I have a range, and I'm trying out these different needles because I'm still looking for the hand sewing needles that work for me, and I think it's all personal preference and it depends on what you like, and I'm still looking for the right fit, like the right size, bendiness, everything. So I'm trying out different brands and I'm excited to try those. And then I also bought a thimble made out of leather. I've been trying to use different thimbles and they're very, very difficult, and I think it's because I use both my fingers, so whenever I pull, I don't have a needle available, but whenever I pull the needle through, I pinch it so that the thread doesn't go everywhere, and it's hard to pinch when you have something hard on your finger, so I thought I'd try a softer leather or thimble, because sometimes, especially when making coat fabrics or when doing a lot of hand sewing, you do end up pushing the needle through with your finger quite a lot and it can start to hurt after a while. So I want to try using this one. And then I also wanted to see how it was made, because I have some old ballet slippers out of leather that I wanted to recycle and make a thimble out of, and I wanted to see how it was made. And it looks pretty simple, so yeah, if it works for me, maybe I'll also make it in some pink ballet slipper material. And then I also got two kits, small kits. I got this one, which is an embroidery kit to make this change purse, and I thought that it was really pretty. I like the color blue, and I like the little flowers. They look really, really cute. And I've never actually tried embroidery before. I've done cross stitching when I was a kid, but not embroidery. And I thought that this looked pretty simple. Those look like French knots, and then I can, you know, figure it out. Even if the instructions are in Japanese, I'm sure with Google Translate, I can figure it out. And so yeah, I wanted to make this. And what I like is that everything's included in the kit, including this clasp. So there's nothing that I have to go buy on the side. And then mentioning cross stitching, I got this cross stitching kit. I thought it was really cute. It's a Lucky Cat. And it looks like you can get it done pretty easily. And it comes with its own frame as well, which is really cool. I thought it would be a nice addition to my sewing corner here. Or somewhere in the house, maybe elsewhere in the house. I think that my fiance would like it too. And yeah, I could probably get this done pretty quickly, so that would be a satisfying make. And I thought it was just really, really cute. And then from Tomato Fabrics, they had a whole wall of fabrics that were 100 yen per meter, and it looked really, really cool. But I didn't find anything that was particularly exceptional, except I did find in another section where there were fabrics, but it wasn't 100 yen per meter, unfortunately. It was about 300 or 400 yen per meter. And I got this fabric. Oh, look at that drape. So it's this like seafoam green. I don't know how it's showing up in the camera. I think it looks a little bit blue on the camera, but it is a little bit greener in real life. And it's just this absolutely gorgeous. Look at how it flows. It's this gorgeous texture. It's more of a heavier weight. Oh, how gorgeous is this? And it has sort of a satiny smooth, not satiny, but it's a smoother finish on the outside, and it's got this texture to it like a silk. And I didn't actually catch what the composition was. I found it, and you had to actually bring the bolt over to the cutting table, which was really interesting. I saw other people doing it too, so I copied. And since I can speak a little bit of Japanese, I asked for 4 meters, and yeah, I was understood. But I forgot to take a picture of the label, and it was all in Japanese, so I didn't read it directly right away. So I'm not sure what it's made of, but it feels natural. It's got more of a twill weave to it. I don't know if you can see close up, but I don't know what it is. Maybe a linen and viscose blend, or I don't think it's silk. I've never done a burn test before. Maybe I'll try a burn test and see, because I do need to wash it before I make it. I think it will shrink a little bit, and I don't want to ruin it because I have 4 meters. And this one, I'd like to make another Highlands wrap dress, which is a pattern by Allie Olson. And I've made it 3 times before, once in a black cupro, once in a polyester fabric, and once in a linen fabric for Minerva. And in the third version, I tried to fiddle with it a little bit by lowering the waist and making the arm side a little bit wider, because sometimes it's a little bit tight in the arm side, but it turned out horrible. I ended up having to fiddle with it a lot to get it to fit correctly, so I will go back to the original pattern. Who cares if it's a little tight in the arm side? I will just make sure to clip correctly around the arm side. And I would like to make this because I think that in a longer dress, it's going to be absolutely gorgeous and just kind of like flow around my legs. I'm so excited, but definitely after the wedding. I'll get to this summer, I think, and I think it's gonna be absolutely gorgeous. So yeah, I'm really happy with this purchase. So that is all that I purchased at the Nippori Fabric Town, and I had a lovely morning. Most of the shops opened at 11, so I didn't actually have to get there that early, and I had a nice time figuring out how to get there. So because I was staying in Asakusa, in Taito, around there, there weren't any direct ways to get there via the metro, and so I tried taking the bus for the first time in Tokyo. It was pretty easy, and the buses aren't too busy like they are in Paris, for example. So I felt very proud of myself on that bus ride on my way to Nippori. And afterwards, I got lunch at a noodle place. It looked really, really good from the outside, and when I walked in, I realized there's no English anywhere on the menu. Everything was in Japanese characters, and nobody spoke English there. Everybody looked like a local. And I decided, you know what, I'm going to figure it out. I was seated and I looked at the menu on my phone because people had taken pictures of what they had eaten there, and one of the dishes looked like miso ramen. So I asked in Japanese, do you have miso ramen? And they said yes, and so I ordered that, and I was very, very proud of myself with my elementary Japanese asking questions and ordering even though I couldn't read the menu. And it was delicious. Oh my goodness. So I was really, really happy. Don't hesitate to try, even if you don't speak Japanese or if you feel scared. I think that some of my best experiences and best meals were in places where I was having a little bit of a hard time and I had to take a risk. So yeah, I was very proud of myself and very well rewarded. There were two other shops that I went to that I wanted to share with you, and one was a really, really beautiful stationery shop called Kyukyodo in Ginza, and I went twice. And the second time was because the first time I didn't have a whole lot of time to browse as much, and I wanted to take my time because there were treasures there, just beautiful paper products and just amazing things to look at. And so I bought two things for my sewing corner there. The first piece that I bought at the stationery shop was this little paper Japanese doll. I love that her hair is made of paper too, and she's really, really beautiful. It was hard to choose which one, but I ended up picking this one, and I'd like to put her in my sewing corner somewhere. And then the second thing that I bought was this portable sewing kit, and it's in this sort of like paper mache covering. And it's got all of the regular things that you find in a sewing kit. For example, scissors, a few extra little bits and bobs, and thread. I think I might replace the thread with more practical colors and quality like waxed thread that I'd pre-cut and wax, just because these colors aren't entirely useful and it looks like a really cheap cotton thread. They look very fuzzy and that's suspicious. I don't have a portable sewing kit, and I think that would be very, very useful. And so yeah, this one was particularly beautiful and I picked this. So another little accessory that I bought for my sewing corner is actually this little lucky cat. So I went to Gotokuji Temple in the southwest of Tokyo to go see the cats, because it's known for these little lucky cats, little, medium, and large, on the side of the temple. And there's a whole story about why this cat is at the temple. And it was really, really cute, and I wanted to take one home with me just to remind me of that beautiful place, and also because he's just adorable. So yeah, he's going to live in my sewing corner now. So that is all the shopping I got up to during my travels for my sewing hobby. Unfortunately, in Taipei, I did try going to the Jihua market, where they have lots and lots of fabric shops. And I did find one, but the fabric was a little expensive and didn't turn out to be what I was looking for. And I went looking for the other fabric shops, but because I went so close to the Lunar New Year, a lot of shops were closed. And I didn't know that the market, the closed market part, had a second floor where all the fabric shops were. And I walked through the first floor where there was all kinds of food stands and a few tailoring shops where people were repairing or tailoring clothes, but I didn't find any fabric shops. And I think that I missed it. I think there might have been some open on the second floor, and I didn't actually have time to go back. So that will be for the next time I go to Taipei. It was a really interesting city with the most friendly people, and it would be a pleasure to go back. So I'll have even more to look forward to going back to that city. It's always lovely being able to bring back creative souvenirs from my travels, and so I was really lucky to have had this time to go explore Nippori Fabric Town. If you do, don't hesitate to check out the link in the description below with the map and the YouTube video that was created by the Nippori Fabric Town. I will be thinking about what I'm going to make with all the fabrics that I purchase. I don't think I'll get to them right away because I have so much sewing to do for my wedding, but it'll be something to look forward to after the wedding, for example, when I will probably have more time to sew. So I am really excited for the next few months. It's going to be really, really intense. I will try to film as much as possible to share everything that's going on. But in the meantime, I hope that you have lots of projects, lots of interesting projects or voyages or creative souvenirs that remind you of your voyages. I wish you very happy sewing. I will see you again here soon. Bye-bye.